Hi, I'm Dominique Weatherspoon, and this is the AI Generation. The AI Generation is a series that will deepen our understanding of GenAI. What is it really? Why is it so important, and what do we need to know? So who's a part of the AI Generation? You are. I am. Some of us might wear ankle socks. And some of us might not. But we are all included in this generation. AI and generative AI are already transforming our lives, and it's just getting started. If you are using GenAI, or even if you're thinking about using it, this episode is for you. We'll cover the impact of GenAI to organizations and data and AI teams, applications of it in the real world, interesting insights from a new global survey, and then move into how your team can use it the right way, and even gain a competitive advantage. Make sure you don't miss our other episodes that will explore trustworthy AI, synthetic data, and natural language processing. Let's dive in. So what are we talking about here? Traditional AI and machine learning systems recognize patterns in data to make predictions. Generative AI is a subset of AI and goes beyond predicting. It generates new data as its primary output. AI expert Mac Carlton is here to help us go beyond the hype of GenAI. Mac, can you tell us more about what GenAI is, how it will impact organizations and potentially transform the workforce?
I'd be happy to. So the way that generative AI learns is that it takes information from billions of data points. It could be text, audio, videos, images, or even code. It understands the patterns among the data, and based off of a human prompt, it generates new content that resembles the real-world data that it learned from. So a way to see it is like a collaborative partner that can help augment human productivity. For data scientists, developers, and other AI team members,
it can seem a little scary,
but it's actually an opportunity. GenAI can empower data and AI teams by automating routine tasks, providing insights, and enhancing their creative process. By staying up to date on AI skills and competencies, team members will be able to collaborate effectively with AI, leveraging its capabilities to drive innovation and achieve goals, rather than fearing replacement. Developers, for example, are always being asked to do more. Now they have this partner in GenAI. Let's talk about how this is already being used in the real world. Imagine you're in the banking industry, for example. You have customer complaints coming in from multiple different sources. You could use natural language processing, a type of GenAI, to analyze and summarize the complaints and then generate hyper-personalized emails to each customer. Another application of GenAI is the creation and use of synthetic data. Synthetic data is, well, exactly what it sounds like. It's generated data that resembles the characteristics of real data, and it has real benefits when the data you have isn't good enough, a large enough data set, or it has sensitive or private information that can't be used for analysis. In the pharmaceutical industry, for example, synthetic data can be used to enrich limited clinical trial data and get safer therapies to market faster. GenAI can also produce digital twins. No, this isn't the start to a horror movie. It's another feature of this technology that can be incredibly useful. A digital twin is a virtual representation of an object or system that exists in the real world. For example, a data and AI team could create a digital twin for their internal systems and then run simulations and a what-if analysis before actually implementing policy in the real world. And we can't forget about copilots and chatbots like ChatGPT. These are large language models and are the type of GenAI that pretty much everyone has used by now. Copilots are like having your own digital assistant. They can help with anything from content creation to coding to training and deploying models faster to decision making and much more. The benefits of generative AI include increased productivity, more personalized experiences, enhanced innovation, cost efficiency, and better decision making, just to name a few.
Thanks, Mac. You can see why GenAI is gaining a ton of traction in the business world. Let's talk a little more about that. Have you ever wondered how your organization compares to others when it comes to GenAI implementation? Well, now you can get some answers. We teamed up with Coleman Parks Research to survey 1,600 decision makers across key sectors globally. You can see here the countries and industries that are leading the way in implementation. China leads in usage, but the US is the leader in full implementation. Industries vary widely in their use of GenAI, from only 40% in manufacturing all the way to 70% in telco. But even those who are lagging a little behind might not be for long, because 86% of leaders surveyed are planning to invest in GenAI in the next fiscal year. 86! And those who have started implementing GenAI are already reaping the benefits. These are some of the early successes organizations are reporting. Risk management and employee satisfaction are way up there, but that doesn't mean there haven't been challenges. 95% of respondents lack a comprehensive governance framework, and 90% aren't fully prepared to comply with current and upcoming regulations. These are pretty important pieces to the puzzle. If you're interested in this research, check out the description box for some additional resources. Mac is back to talk us through how we can start addressing some of these challenges.
Thanks, Dominique. Let's dive right in. The next 5 years will determine which organizations succeed in this new GenAI-powered economy and which will not. Those who succeed will pay attention to the deeper challenges and complexities of integrating GenAI. Good AI starts with good data, so we have to invest in data infrastructure to ensure that it's clean, diverse, and accessible across departments. Next, we have to prioritize governance and responsible AI from day one. AI that isn't trusted will never be fully embraced and can introduce more risk than reward. So it's crucial to establish a strong governance framework that will cover bias detection, model explainability, and data privacy. Also, we have to tie every GenAI initiative to strategic goals and measurable outcomes. It shouldn't be treated like an experiment. It needs to be integrated into our core processes so teams work with it instead of around it. Also, taking a platform approach is a smart move. One of the mistakes organizations and AI teams have made is adopting different tools for different tasks, leading to confusion, complexity, and a disaggregated stack. An end-to-end platform improves flexibility, reduces technical debt, and allows proper integration of GenAI across existing processes and people. Finally, recognize that this is the worst GenAI will ever be, so choose to stay flexible. One of the mistakes that organizations have made is to invest money in fine-tuning a specific large language model, and now they have technical debt. Models will only get better. The key is to build a framework and approach to plug and play any model, not to build specifics to a certain one.
Thanks, Mac. I think some of you might want to save this video to share with your coworkers. It's good stuff. So we've covered what GenAI is, how implementation is looking right now across the globe, and how we can overcome hurdles and get ahead in the race. We're officially past the hype stage for AI and GenAI. It's time to get strategic, define clear AI objectives, pilot small-scale projects, invest in talent and training, ensure you're using AI ethically, and collaborate with experts. Subscribe below so you can catch all of our episodes. We'll cover trustworthy AI, synthetic data, and natural language processing in depth. You won't want to miss them. And leave us a comment on your thoughts or ask a question. If you feel like learning more, check out the resources in the description. That's all for now. I'll see you next time on The AI Generation.